So you guys know that I love the iPhone 12 mini so much because of its small form factor that allows me to use it with one hand, that I was super reluctant to switch over to the iPhone 12 Pro Max after finishing the review. Because the iPhone 12 Pro Max seriously is a phone that's too large to handle. But after using for a month, I finally found several key benefits that would keep me using for the rest of 2021. This is Warren with KL Gadget TV, and here are my thoughts about the iPhone 12 Pro Max. So I recently switched back to the iPhone 11 Pro Max as my video guy needed the 12 Pro Max to produce this video. Then I instantly realized how easy it is to handle compared to its successor. While I absolutely love the 12 Pro Max's blocky design and a shiny glossy frame, it is very difficult to handle single-handedly due to a 0.2-inch difference in screen size and its 228g weight. Even the Galaxy Note 20 Ultra 5G, which has a larger display than the 12 Pro Max, feels slightly easier to handle due to its shorter width and its 20g slider. To be honest, I expected better scratch resistance on the iPhone 12 Pro Max, even though Apple claims that the glass is stronger with its ceramic shield coating. But without putting on a screen protector for the first few days and some extra care being taken, my unit's front glass already got a couple of nasty scratches and it's still visible even after I applied a screen protector. So don't make the same mistake like me. Get a screen protector from the day you unbox your iPhone 12 Pro Max. Now, I'm not going to go through all the features of iOS 14 again in this review as I've covered what I'd like on my iPhone 12 mini review. But in the case of the iPhone 12 Pro Max, it has a problem because of that huge screen size. We already talked about how bad one-handed usability is and Apple isn't doing anything on the software level to make navigating around a big screen better. For instance, I can't do a simple swipe gesture to shrink the keyboard or screen, which made me stretch my thumb all the time if I want to switch to a different language. Pulling down the notification center and control center requires an effort to tilt the phone, unless you remember to swipe down on the dock to bring it down, which requires a two-time action. This is something Apple really needs to address since they're already making phones this big. Otherwise, the 12 Pro Max is a very enjoyable device if you mostly handle it with two hands, especially when you are gaming, watching movies, and texting in landscape. Up to this point, you already detect that I am mostly negative about the iPhone 12 Pro Max, but its camera system is the one reason that I'm going to look past all that and keep using it. The iPhone 12 Pro Max's main camera features a large 1.7 micron pixel size and f1.6 aperture, along with a sensor shift optical stabilization hardware. This is probably the best smartphone camera I've ever come across that performs exceptionally well in both low light photos and videos at this point of time. It is also able to capture pro raw uncompressed images that some power users would appreciate. I am particularly impressed that the camera is able to maintain good colors and some amount of detail in extreme dim lighting, which no Android flagships I've tested can achieve, especially in videos. With the LiDAR sensor, portrait lighting works noticeably better than the iPhone 12 as it assists the camera to differentiate object and background. The iPhone 12 Pro Max's telephoto lens has a longer focal length than the Pro, which results in a 2.5x optical zoom, but the slower f2.2 aperture makes it less ideal in low light and indoor shots. But otherwise, it delivers decent looking photos in good lighting. Compared to many other flagship phones I've tested, the iPhone 12 Pro Max's ultra-wide camera is outstanding and it is all thanks to Apple's Deep Fusion tech that makes details look great. But just don't use it in low light. The iPhone 12 Pro Max continues to deliver a stellar battery life like its predecessor when it comes to general productivity usage. It does take a slight hit as usual if you are doing heavy gaming and shooting videos. Due to its larger battery size and optimized charging feature, the phone takes around 90 minutes to get fully charged with Apple's USB-C 20W adapter. I'll usually only need to charge the phone a day later if I don't have access to the charger.
So there you have it, the iPhone 12 Pro Max is a big upgrade over the iPhone 11 Pro Max when it comes to their cameras, and that alone is already sufficient to keep me using for the rest of 2021. But of course, once again, this is not a phone for everyone due to its expensive price tag, and unless you appreciate the set of pro features that comes in this phone, otherwise, the standard iPhone 12 will work for you just as well. As for iPhone 11 Pro Max users, you might want to ponder about getting the iPhone 12 Pro Max as your next upgrade because this phone is really too big to handle and you will really feel it once you pick one up. and I'm sure you will still prefer the handling of the iPhone 11 Pro Max. So that's pretty much about my review about the iPhone 12 Pro Max after using it for a month. It's a great phone and I really love what Apple has brought to the table this time. It's just that it's too big. So stay tuned for more videos coming right up over at KL Gadget TV. Be sure to subscribe to us for more videos coming right up and I will see you in our next video.